Hello everyone. In class 7th, you have learnt about powers with negative integers as exponents, laws of exponents and standard form of very large numbers. But in class 8th, now we will do in this chapter exponent introduction, powers with negative exponents and expanding decimal numbers using exponents, laws of exponents and standard form of very small numbers and comparison of very large and very small numbers. Children, we have already learned in class 7th how to write such type of large numbers. It is difficult to read and write. So how we are writing using exponent? See, 5 is followed by 15 zeros. So we are writing it by 5 into 10 raised to power 15. This is using exponent. So 5 is followed by 15 zeros. So we will write 5 into 10 raised to power 15. Here 10 is the base and 15 is the power or exponent. So what is a exponent? A number that refers to number of times base number is to be multiplied. See, 10 raised to power 2 means how many times this represent, how many times base multiplied. So 10 raised to power 2 means 10 is multiplied 2 times. 2 raised to power 5 means 2 is multiplied 5 times. Same way, a raised to power m means a multiplied m times. Here 10 raised to power 2, it doesn't mean you multiply 10 into 2. It will be wrong. So 10 raised to power 2 means 10 is multiplied 2 times. It will come. Now see, powers with negative exponents. How do we find the powers with negative exponents? First of all, consider one example, 2 raised to power 3. This is the positive power. So 2 raised to power 3 means 2 is multiplied 3 times. 2 raised to power 2 means 2 is multiplied 2 times. 2 raised to power 1 means 2 alone. Alone 2 will come here. Here you are observing that this number we are getting when previous number is divided by the base 2. When this number is divided by base 2, you will get this. When you divide this number by 2, you will get the next number. When you will divide this number by the base 2, this is the base. When you divide by the base 2, you will get next number. It means we are observing here the next number we are getting. How? By dividing the base of previous number. So how you will get 2 raised to power minus 1? Means next power how you will get? When you divide the previous number by base 2. So you will get this. Now next how you will get 2 raised to power minus 2? When you divide this previous number by base 2. Now divide this number by base 2, you will get 1 raised to power 1 upon 2 raised to power 2. So we have observed here that this side power is decreasing by 1. 2 raised to power 3, 2 raised to power 2, 2 raised to power 1, 2 raised to power 0, then minus 1. It means power is decreasing here by 1 and here the previous number is divided by base 2. Here the previous number is divided by base 2. Previous number is divided by this previous number divide, you will get this. Previous number divide, you will get this. This way, similarly, a raised to power minus m will come 1 upon a raised to power m. Because here, 2 raised to power minus 2, what it will come? The result is 1 upon 2 raised to power 2. Same number but with positive integer. Here, same number but with 1 upon a raised to power m means positive integer will come here. So in general, for any non-zero integer a raised to power minus m, what it will come? 1 upon a raised to power m. Take this example. Suppose 10 raised to power minus 4 will come and you have to convert it into positive power. So you write this number without negative sign, means it will become positive when you will take it in the denominator, 1 upon 10 raised to power 4. when positive power come will here, will come here, make it negative by taking it in the denominator. So whenever this will come here, when you will take this up, negative power will come same way. What is the reciprocal of or multiplicative inverse of any known zero integer? Suppose a is any known zero integer, then what is the reciprocal of a raised to power negative power will come then a raised to power m. A raised to power minus m, reciprocal of this number is a raised to power m. Example, reciprocal of 2 raised to power minus 1 will, minus 4 will 2 raised to power 4. Children, what is the meaning of 2 raised to power minus 4? We can write 1 upon 2 raised to power 4. This is the meaning. But when we have to find out the reciprocal of 2 raised to power minus 4, it means reciprocal of this number, and reciprocal means denominator will become numerator. So it will become numerator. So this is the reciprocal of 2 raised to power minus 4. Similarly, I am doing one more example. 7 raised to power minus 2. It means 1 upon 7 raised to power 2. And reciprocal means it will come in numerator. So reciprocal will be 7 raised to power 2. So reciprocal of 7 raised to power minus 2 is 7 raised to power 2. Power will be changed. Sign will change only. Minus 2 here, positive 2. So in the reciprocal, their sign will change. We learnt how to write expanded form of numbers like this. We were doing 1 into 10 raised to power 3 or 1000 plus 400 plus 20 plus 5, and we can write it as 1 into 10 raised to power 3, 4 into 10 raised to power 2, 2 into 10 raised to power 1, and 5 into 10 raised to power 0. But when it will come like this decimal number, how we will do the expanded form? Now see, 1 is on, this is on the 1's place, this is on 10th, 100 place, 1000 place, this is 10th place, and this is 100th place, DTHS. You have learned this in 6th class also. Now how you will express the expanded form in the exponential form? First of all, I'll write the expanded form of this number. 1 into 1000 means 10 raised to power 3, 4 into 100 means 10 raised to power 2, 100 means 10 raised to power 2, and here 2 on the 10th place, so 2 into 10 raised to power 1, and 5 is on the 1's place, so 5 into 10 raised to power 0 will come, plus 3 is on the 10th place, means 3 by 10. 3 by 10 means 3 into 1 by 10. And how we can write 1 upon 10? 10 raised to power minus 1. And here 6 is on the 100th place. So we can write 6 into 1 upon 100. And 1 upon 100, we can write 10 raised to power minus 2. 1 upon 100 means 1 upon 10 raised to power 2, and we can write 1 upon 10 raised to power as 10 raised to power minus 2 also. So we can write it as 6 into 10 raised to power minus 2. This is the decimal expansion. Take one more example. Now we have to write the expanded form of this number using exponents. So first of all, we'll see the places. This is the 1000 place, so we will write 1000. 0, leave this, because 0 we can leave. Otherwise you can write 0 into 10 raised to power 2, because this is on the 100 place, so you can leave also. And 2 is on the 10th place, So what will come 20. 5 is on the 1's place. Write down 5 as it is. 6 is on the 10th place. 6 upon 10. After decimal this place is. So 6 upon 10 will come. 3 is on the 100th place. So it will come 3 upon 100. But we have to write this number in the exponential form, or using exponents we have to show this, express this. So 1000 we can write 1 into 10 raised to power 3. 20 means 2 into 10 raised to power 1. 5 was alone, so 5 into 10 raised to power 0. 10 raised to power 0 means 1. 6 into 10 raised to power minus 1, because it was 6 into 1 by 10. 1 by 10 we can write 10 into 10 raised to power minus 1. 3 upon 100 means 3 into 10 raised to power minus 2. This way we can do more examples. Laws of exponents. We have learnt first law of exponent, a raised to power m into a raised to power n is equal to a raised to power m plus n. We have done this rule or law in class 7 also, but for positive integers. Now we will check that this same law will hold if the exponents will be negative. Let us see now. I am taking one example. Suppose I am taking 2 raised to power minus 3 into 2 raised to power minus 2. Without law, when I will solve this, 2 raised to power minus 3 means 1 upon 2 raised to power 3, and 2 raised to power minus 2 means 1 upon 2 raised to power 2. It means 1 upon 2 raised to power 3 and 2, it will become 1 upon 2 raised to power 5. So how do we write? This can be written as 2 raised to power minus 5. This can be written as 2 raised to power minus 5, and minus 5 is the sum of minus 3 and minus 2. So we can say this is the sum of minus 3 and minus 2. So the laws hold here. A raised to power m into a raised to power n is the a raised to power m plus n. Means this way we can verify other laws of exponent also. Now see the second law. A raised to power m divided by a raised to power n is equal to a raised to power m minus n. Now see the example on it. 2 raised to power 5 divided by 2 raised to power minus 6. Now according to rule, we will subtract the both the powers. So 5 minus second power is n, means minus 6. So 5 minus 6, minus of minus 6 will become plus, and 5 and 6, 11 will come. So here it will come 2 raised to power 11. Now the third law of exponent, a raised to power m again raised to power n, it will be equal to a raised to power m into n, means we will multiply both the powers. Example of it, 7 raised to power 2 raised to power minus 4. Now base will remain same and powers will be multiplied. 2 into minus 4, it will become minus 8. 7 raised to power minus 8. Now fourth law is a raised to power m into b raised to power m is equal to a into b raised to power m. Here the powers are same. So we will write the same power and bases will be multiplied here. See the example on it. 4 raised to power minus 3 into minus 2 raised to power minus 3. Here the both the powers are same. So write the power same, and base you have to multiply. You will get the answer minus 8 raised to power minus 3. Now come to fifth law, a raised to power m divided by b raised to power m. It means the power is again same, but the base are divided here. So a upon b raised to power, collectively we will write a upon b, and power we will write once only, same power m. Example, minus 5 raised to power 3 divided by 2 raised to power 3. Here the power is same, so we will write the power here, and by the rule we will divide the base, minus 5 upon 2 raised to power 3. This is the result. Now the last law, that is a raised to power 0 equal to 1, where a is any integer. So we can take any example. You can write here any integer, minus 100, like I have taken minus 100 raised to power 0. All the integers, any number will come and power 0 will come. The result is 1 always. This is all about the laws of exponents.